Hi, Olof here. By chance, I ran across this brand new Husqvarna HC8, and that's a bike that I wanted to try out for a very long time, but I haven't had the chance to. First and foremost, this is only a first impressions video for me because I only have this bike for like an hour or so, something like that. But I have this bike in a bike park where I can test some really gnarly enduro trails. Swedish Cup is taking place here tomorrow. So these are the trails that are being used for the Swedish Enduro Cup. Oh, it's so easy to ride these red trails with this bike. This is a proper enduro bike. So much travel in the front and in the rear. It's crazy. It's 180. 180 in the front, 180 in the rear. So absolutely no problem going down these trails. Good tires too. I don't know what brand it is. I have to check that later. And what this bike is a hardcore enduro bike, unlike any other e-mount bike that I've tested before. It's got 27.5-inch wheels, both front and rear, for extra durability of course, but also to make this bike a little bit more nimble between the trees. So this particular bike has got a Fox 38. I think that is an e-bike specific Fox 38. So in the rear, that's a new Fox X2 shock. I think it replaces the DP X2, don't quote me on that. But that's a brand new Fox X2, and that's very exciting of course because I haven't tested that before. So there are a couple of things that differs this bike from other e-mountain bikes, and the first thing I noticed was this plate is a bash plate. It does look as if this bash guard is made out of some kind of aluminium or something, but it's actually made out of plastic, but apparently it's unbreakable more or less, they say. Then as it should be on proper enduro bikes, there is a chain steerer here, chain guard. And I really like the colors of this bike. These are Husqvarna colors. And this yellow link here really stands out. And the motor mount is also very different from other e-mountain bikes. It looks very special. So one thing that's apparent with this bike is that it's extremely capable. I've never tested an e-mountain bike that rides like this bike does. I went down a trail after my brother on another e-mountain bike, and he is usually a better rider than I am. But in sections where he had trouble getting down, I just flew down like it was nothing. That's not because of me, I'm just an average mountain biker, but this bike makes me feel like a king in the trails. I have no idea about the geometry of this bike. This is a size medium bike, so it's way too small for me, but immediately I can tell it gives me loads of confidence, this bike. So if you are having trouble riding red trails, then you should try out something like this. I don't think this shows on camera, but this is actually really steep, and it climbs very well too, this bike. Yeah, climbing up that slalom hill is a breeze, and it's so nice to just get up to the top and feel rested when you're hitting some enduro trails on the way down. I have to throw everything I knew about geometry and wheel sizes out the window. Despite the fact that this frame is a bit dated, it practically chews challenging trails for breakfast. Top level components, long travel, and a weight at around 25 kilos is part of that explanation. Of course, this isn't the easiest bike to get up in the air, but I managed to have some fun anyway. This bike can change directions pretty quickly as well.
So, a surprisingly capable bike, and big thank you to Husqvarna and to Pro E-Bike for letting me lend in this bike. See you in the next video.